Hey, what's going on, guys? In today's video, I want to show you how you can cut shapes into multiple pieces inside of Affinity Designer. So I have made a video similar to this previously, but I've recently deleted that as I was having a few sound issues with my earlier videos where the voice was only playing through one side of the headphones or speaker. And I had a lot of people keep reporting it and telling me it was ruining the video. So I decided to delete that one and remake it as it was quite a popular video. So first, to get started, we are just going to come over and grab any shape that you want to choose. I'm just going to go for a diamond. I'm just going to hold down shift and just drag that out to keep that proportion perfect. And you can do this with any shape you like. So we'll just grab a few different shapes here just to demonstrate. Hold down shift again and just get a circle. We'll hold down shift again. I'll just give these a color so you can see them a bit more clearly on your screens. There we go. So as of June 10th, 2021, this is the only way that I am aware of myself that you can cut shapes into pieces. If any of you guys know a different way of doing this, then please let me know. I'm always looking to learn myself. So for those of you who just want to learn my way of doing this, then we'll get started. So first of all, choose your shape that you want to cut. We'll start off with a diamond. And then what we need to do is convert this shape into curves. And generally what that means is it then makes it a custom shape once we convert it into curves. And to do that, we've just got to go all the way up to the top, straight up. And we've got this tab here that says convert to curves. So if you tap on that, and after we've done that, we've just got to come over to the left-hand side and we've got to grab this node tool right there, that little white kind of triangle there. And once we've done that, you see we've got these four points now around the diamond. And what we can do with these is use these to cut. So if we select this top one here and we just hold down shift and we select this bottom one while holding shift, that will highlight both of those in blue. So once you've done that, if you come up here to this action menu right there on your top menu bar, you've got this tab here that says break curve. So if you hit that, that now has gave us that in half. You can't see it right now, but you can see it over here in the layers. But if we just grab the move tool, we are now able to pull that apart just like that. And one thing to note, which is always good practice, is if we go back to the node tool, you'll see at the moment these aren't connected, and it's always good to close your paths so this becomes a full shape. It can cause issues further down the line if you start to manipulate it a little bit too much and it may not color correctly. So just to close this, we're going to select that top one, come down to the bottom one, hold down shift again, highlight both of these, and then we'll come back to the action menu. And this time we've got the close tab right there. So close curve, and you hit that one, and now that becomes a triangle. Just like that. So you can see this one's still open, but this one is still closed. So if we want to cut this again now, it's just a case of we just go and grab that node tool, or make sure that we are on that node tool. And anywhere along this path, you see this blue line has appeared. We can just put ourselves another node in here, which are what these little squares are called. So we're going to line up with that one there. So just let that snap into place. And just like that. So if we now hold down shift over here as well and highlight that one blue, we've got both of these highlighted. And once again, you just got to break that. And we can just simply grab that move tool and pull it apart. Just like that. But once again, these are now open shapes as well. So you may just want to come back in here and close those as well. That's entirely up to you if you want to or you don't. And it's obviously the same process across any of these shapes. So if we do the same here, first of all, we've got to convert it to curves so it becomes a custom shape. And we do that with a tab up there, convert to curves. Then we go ahead and choose the node tool. And we can just come from any angle you like. We can select that one there if you like and come down here. Just hold that shift button, highlight both of these, and just come up here and break the curve. And once again, we grab that move tool and we can just pull that apart. And like stated before, it is an open path, so we can just select both of those and we can just go and close that. So I want to give you a quick demonstration why you would close a shape and what will happen if you don't, for instance. So if we go ahead and select this side here, we'll leave this open right now. But what I'm going to do is we're going to make sure we're on that node tool again. I'm going to select that one and I'm going to come down and I'm going to hold shift and select that one. So now what will happen when I break this curve is going to go really funny. Just watch up here as we go break curve. See that? That's obviously not what we wanted to do. So if I just hit Command Z to go back And before we do this again, I'm just going to close this. So select that one, hold down shift and close that one as well. And now if we perform that exact same one, it will work correctly this time because we closed the shape. So we're going to select that one, come down here, select that one, break that curve. And this time it's exactly what we were looking for, as you can see. So just remember, it's always good practice to close your shapes once you've got the shape you are happy with and you know you want to keep it. And like I said, it's the same across any shape whatsoever. So just convert to curves first of all, as it does have to be a custom shape, and that's what that does. And then we just select them, no tools, and we break that curve. And then simply pull it apart, just like that. And you can continue just cutting this as small as you like. It is entirely up to you. Just add your own points anywhere you want. And simply just select both of those and break that curve. And you just cut that as many times as you like. So I know straight away there's going to be people out there that may even comment saying that this is too much effort for a simple effect. And you can do it so much easier in Adobe Illustrator. So first of all, I completely agree with you. It is definitely easier to do in Adobe Illustrator. And I just want to show you that I do in fact own Adobe Illustrator myself. I don't tend to use it that much these days as I prefer Affinity now. There isn't anything that you can't do inside of Affinity that you can do on Illustrator. Yeah, there's a couple more steps involved, but hopefully one day Affinity will just step their game up and make it a lot easier. So that is enough of rambling on about all that. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, then please give me a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button, as it makes all the difference. And let me know if there's anything in particular that you would like to learn in the comments. But for now, have a great day and I will see you in the next video.